The doctor called me and he just said, there seems to be a level a little bit elevated. You know, we just need to retest it. Not a big deal. We retested it, and within 2 days, the level had doubled. And then that's when they had said, well, we need to do your 20-week sonogram early so that we could see exactly what's going on. And when they did the 20-week sonogram, they were able to see that Gemma had what's called gastroschisis, which is the birth defect of the abdominal wall, where her intestines were still outside of her body.
They were terrified. Surgery was involved from day one, and it's scary. They handled it really well. They were there every single day. Jen was there all day, every day. Lewis was there whenever he could be. And we just all bonded really well.
To see, you know, your daughter hooked up to all these machines in an incubator, and obviously we weren't able to hold her till 5 days after she was born. That was really hard to see her, and I hadn't held her yet.
She was an adorable infant. I fell in love with her. And she was cranky a lot because she was hungry, because she wasn't allowed to eat, so I just spent a lot of time holding her, and there was just, I just had a connection with her, and I ended up just primarying her, and I was taking care of her pretty frequently.
I'll never forget one of the times she had a pretty bad setback, and I walked in and they were actually doing x-rays in the room. And the huge x-ray machine was like over her, and everyone has to step outside the room. And Christy, of course, had her that day, and she just like came up to me and hugged me. And you know, it was just so nice to know that people really care that much.
I was nervous for her too. Every time something was off with Gemma, you're scared that you're thinking she's gonna need another surgery. It definitely can be hard because you become emotional and you kind of become attached to them, and it's like you're going through it with them. I see her on Facebook, I see how well she's doing, and you feel proud that we all helped her get there.
Gemma was doing so well, and she was very healthy compared to a lot of other NICU babies, thankfully. The surgeons and the doctors were like, you can bring in a bouncer seat. You know, she's well enough that she could sit in here. You know, she doesn't want to lay in a crib all day. Christy helped me put together this like bouncer seat. It was just so great because then every time I came in, she had Gemma in it, and she always had like headbands on her. All of a sudden, one of the surgeons came in to check on her. They were rounding. He's like, I think she can go home today. And the first thing that went through my mind is, but I don't even have a car seat in. Christy actually came running down the hall, and she was like, I just heard, she's being released. And just like that, after 35 days, she went home.
She wrote me a card when she was discharged, and I still have it, to know that she will always remember me, and I will be somebody that Gemma will learn about later on. It feels really good. There's really nothing better, and I really couldn't imagine working anywhere else.
It just means so much, probably more than they realize, when they go that extra mile, when they treat, you know, a patient like their family, you know, when they spend that extra time, when they give that hug, you know, just giving that little extra bit just means the world.